Good evening. Breaking news, tropical cyclone Jasper is hammering into the far north Queensland coast as we go to air tonight. The system is right now making landfall, bringing ferocious winds and bucketing rain. We're taking you into the heart of the emergency tonight with special live coverage from our Nine News team in all of the major impact zones. And of course, for this major weather event, we begin with our weather expert, Garry Youngberry, who is in the thick of it at Palm Cove tonight. Garry, Cyclone Jasper is here. What is it doing right now?
Oh, Melissa, I'm certainly in the thick of it. I can assure you I am in the zone of the destructive core that surrounds the eye of the storm. The wind at the moment, well, it is storm force. There are sustained wind gusts of 115 kilometres per hour. It is stripping the bark from the trees, the foliage at the moment, and the rain torrential coming in absolutely sideways. Jasper is a Category 2 storm. We could still see winds to 140 kilometres per hour. It will track inland overnight and weaken to a tropical low, but it'll continue to tap into the moisture from the Coral Sea and bring heavy rain well into tomorrow. Big waves are pounding the coast, and that will swallow up most of our beaches as well. We do have a radar image, a great image of the moisture that's rotating and spiralling around. You can see the eye of the storm that stretches from Cooktown down to around Cape Tribulation, but we are just about in the middle of that eye of the storm. It's not that far away, but it'll continue, Melissa, well into the evening and into early hours of Thursday.
We'll talk to you then, Garry. Thank you. Well, we had to wait for Jasper's arrival, the system slowing and growing in power as it approached the coast. And now that the Category 2 system is striking, it really is packing a punch.
Cyclone Jasper bearing down. He's wild and angry. Destructive winds causing damage right across Port Douglas. Dougie's backpack is belted, bringing down trees.
Just have a look at one of these gusts coming through. This is what happens. They ease off for a moment and then they come roaring through.
Christmas holidays on pause while Jasper unleashes on the tropics. It spent the day teasing the far north Queensland coast, edging towards land, speeding up, then slowing down. Destructive wind gusts of 120 kilometres an hour have been recorded. Jasper right now smashing into Queensland as a Category 2 cyclone. The eye of the storm over Cape Tribulation tonight, where homes have been damaged.
It's just made an absolute mess, and we've still got round two to come.
The rainfall, however, the impacts will linger for quite a few days.
The rain hurts us when it hits us. It's so strong.
Where are you guys from? Where are you?
Denmark.
We're not used to this.
The deteriorating conditions coincided with the 9:30 a.m. high tide. The ocean churning furiously. This cyclist braving the elements to take a picture at Palm Cove. Nearby, the Ellis Beach caravan park was flooded, the beach eroding away by the force of the waves.
Oh, they were coming a metre over land as it was, so big.
The beaches from Port Douglas down to Cairns are all taking a hammering. The waves so big, some surfers couldn't resist. Even after all the warnings.
This is not the time to go driving around. This is not the time for children to go playing in the floodwaters because it is simply not safe to do so.
The mangroves are giving luxury yachts and catamarans cover from Jasper. Vessels evacuated from the marina sheltered on Dixon Inlet.
So I'm in between rain at the moment, it's pretty good, and it's what you do, you come up and you check the foredeck, make sure the ropes are good going out to the shore, your anchor chains down there, good.
But some haven't been able to escape the wrath of Jasper.
Looks like the cyclone has claimed its first victim.
Right across the far north, main roads are closed due to landslides, massive trees falling and flooding. Wild wind gusts early this morning brought trees down on the Cairns waterfront and in the main street, a tropical holiday so many tourists will never forget.
I came here to go snorkeling and a shop.
The snorkeling will have to wait. Cairns Marina abandoned all bar a lonely jet ski. Fences have come crashing down.
These fences down here, they're bolted down, but the sheer strength of these winds has just ripped it right off the hinges.
The fight is not over. The next 24 hours will be critical. We're expecting up to 500 millimetres of rain, which is likely to cause flash flooding.
A flying branch smacked into a power pole. Close to 15,000 people tonight without power, a number likely to grow. Cairns Airport is well and truly closed, 93 flights cancelled so far. Residents told it's too late to relocate. It's time to shelter in place, which is what most far north Queenslanders are doing, riding out Jasper with a drink in hand, of course. Authorities in the southeast and far north of the state watching Jasper closely tonight, a night that will be sleepless for so many. Jessica Millward, Nine News.
Let's go live now to Cam Inglis at Yorkeys Knob, which is just north of Cairns. Cam, you've been in the elements all day, but conditions must be intensifying now.
Yeah, they certainly are, Melissa. We are getting absolutely smashed here. The conditions certainly are getting worse. The winds now are really picking up. The rain right now, it almost feels like hail. It is stinging so much. I haven't been pummeled this much since high school. We've had a few people here coming to Sticky Beak, but the conditions are now so bad that they basically had to retreat to their cars as quickly as possible. The swell out here, the waves are just going berserk right now as this Category 2 cyclone really is whipping up into a frenzy. The wind is just building and building and building, and if you're outside of the tree line, well, I tell you what, you can feel every minute of it. We had a chat to a few people earlier who came out to brave the elements but quickly ran away. Have a listen to what they had to say.
This is not what I expected to get visiting. Yeah, definitely. It's very wet and windy.
So I was actually just come down to try and catch a barra, but lost a lure in a tree.
Lived here for a long time, and this is as big as it gets.
Nothing happens at Yorkies.
Now, Melissa, it's really continuing to get. The trees are absolutely swaying. There's a handrail almost there to hold on. You're absolutely blowing across. Right now, this wind is continuing to pick up. It's gotten worse in the last 10 minutes and is continuing to go and go and go. So hopefully out there, everyone is safe during this cyclone.
It is a wild scene, Cam. Thank you. We'll cross straight to Josh Bavis now in Port Douglas. Josh, how's the town coping as those winds pick up?
Well, Melissa, you can hear the roar of the wind and the rain howling through McCrossan Street, the main street in Port Douglas. It's ripping up trees and just shredding the vegetation. We're hearing bangs and clatters as we stand here at the entrance of a concrete garage where it is safe, but everyone is tucked away inside their homes. Just think of those storms in southeast Queensland, but imagine it lasting for hour after hour after hour. That's what's happening here in Port Douglas. I have to spare a thought for the folks up at Cape Tribulation and in the Woodjul community because they're copping the brunt of it right now. We're about 50-60 k's from the system where we are here and we're really getting it. We haven't been able to see all the damage that has occurred yet, but we will hope to see that in the coming day.
The impact is so widespread, isn't it, Josh? Thank you for that. Let's go live now to Mia Glover in Cairns. Mia, what sort of damage is Jasper doing around the city?
Well, at the moment I can barely open my eyes because these winds are just so strong, Melissa. I'll just get you to have a look at the Esplanade at the moment. It's absolutely whipping up trees, uprooting them from their bases. You can see there's branches scattered all around the Esplanade, even in the middle of the city as well in Cairns. It's uprooted some more trees. We also saw today a power box completely explode, and that has caused major dramas for so many people here in Cairns. Around 16,000 homes and businesses, as we go to air tonight, are without electricity, and a lot of people have been told to stay inside and hunker down, so a lot of them will be doing that without power. Of course, there is a big concern for those 15,000 residents that were in the red zone. They were evacuated yesterday due to flooding concerns. That is likely to happen a little later tonight, around 8:30 or so, so it is a very nervous wait and see for them. But for now, it's an eerie feeling here in Cairns. I mean, we're in December. This is just before Christmas, the peak of the school holidays, really. A lot of people would be here enjoying their school holidays and having fun, but there's no one inside, Melissa.
You're on your own there, Mia. Take cover soon. Thank you. We'll go now to Andrea Crothers at Cooktown on the northern edge of Cyclone Jasper. Andrea, there was a lot of worry about how the winds might affect this town. How is it faring tonight?
Good evening, Melissa. Well, this is typically a quite gusty town, belted by winds, but even today it seemed to be a lot less windy and blowy than normally. Now, the hospital landline phones, they are currently down, but all calls are being diverted to mobiles. The cyclone shelter, which only had a handful of people there, well, they have since left there, and it's also been shut down altogether. As for businesses, which remained cautiously closed this morning, they have since opened their doors. Only around 26 millimetres of rain fell in Cooktown today. That's because we're in the northwest quadrant of the cyclone, which is typically the driest. So locals, tourists today, they were fairly relaxed.
The locals seem very calm and relaxed about the whole show, so I just go along with that.
Should be all sweet, just a bit of piss and wind, I hope.
Now, with some heavy rainfall still forecast, there is still a chance that the town could be isolated for a day or so should that main access road to the south to Cairns be cut off. But, Melissa, it appears that Cooktown has escaped the worst of it.
And they're all breathing a sigh of relief, I bet. Andrea, thank you. Well, from the northern edge of this storm to just south of it, let's cross live to Lily Greer at Flying Fish Point in Innisfail. Lily, with Jasper moving inland now, are things beginning to calm down where you are?
Yeah, well, here at Flying Fish Point east of Innisfail, we've seen lots of rain and wind today. Still a bit of drizzle, but I can tell you just in the last hour or so, we have seen conditions ease right up. Still, I'll show you out there on the water. Conditions are still very, very choppy. You would not want to be out there right now. Plenty of cloud coverage at the moment as Cyclone Jasper moves in. And would you believe it, there are locals here who are actually happy about the downpours that we've had today. Plenty of properties here rely on rain tanks, and it's been a dry couple of months, so they're happy to see those filling up. But one gentleman who was not so happy about the weather today was Dave Pedley. We met him not long after intense wind brought a tree and power lines crashing down on his four-wheel drive. A very dangerous situation there. Take a listen.
Yeah, just driving home and, tree fell out with all the power lines on the bonnet.
What did you see when the tree came down, power line came down?
Just a heap of trees and a heap of sparks and flames and the smell of burning plastic and stuff.
How lucky do you feel to be alive right now?
Oh, yeah, pretty lucky, yeah.
So lucky, in fact, Dave tells me he is going to buy a lotto ticket today. We know that Ergon worked, Energex worked very, very quickly to get those power lines back up and running in the area. But as for how this region is going to fare into the evening, we know that the Bureau is forecasting some damaging wind gusts that are possible in the area. So locals here have worked quickly to get prepared. They've tied down loose items at their property, ready for whatever comes their way tonight, Melissa.
They've been through it before, haven't they, Lily? Thank you. Let's check in now with Olivana Lathouris, who's at Ellis Beach, which is just north of Palm Cove. Ollie, the coastline there, it is being battered right now.
Yeah, battered is the word, Melissa. We were speaking to a couple earlier today who said they'd nicknamed Jasper the friendly cyclone. But let me tell you, there is nothing friendly about the weather conditions we're experiencing here tonight. You can probably see behind me that ocean is a brown, aggressive mess, and it's moving closer and closer here to these bungalows, which are right on the beachfront. Even the sand that I am standing on, it was not here this morning. It has been washed up by that tide. Now, the tide this morning was supposed to be the biggest of the day. Tonight's one is not supposed to be as big, although it will be bolstered by a very strong storm surge. So unfortunately, that flooding that we saw here earlier today at the holiday park is still very much a possibility. We're still about 2.5 hours or so away from the peak. So unfortunately, it seems as though the conditions here, the worst of it is unfortunately yet to come. And as all of our other reporters have said tonight, the conditions are becoming more and more and more intense. So still a very long and anxious night ahead for those in this area, Melissa.
And Ollie, what have the locals been saying to you about how they're feeling about this, you know, the worst still to come?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we spoke to the manager and the owner of this holiday park here, and you know, they are very nervous. He said he's been here for well over 25 years, and these conditions are making him, yeah, really anxious. And you know, they put a lot of effort into these cabins recently. It's supposed to be a beautiful time of year here, a great time to come and enjoy a waterfront view, but certainly not today and not this week. And all they can do is hope that they'll be able to get back on their feet as soon as possible.
We will go now to the state's disaster management headquarters. Peter Fegan is there. Peter, you're in the nerve centre of this emergency response. What's the latest from authorities?
Well, good evening to you, Melissa. I'm joined by Assistant Commissioner Ben Marcus, who will run us through. Assistant Commissioner, thank you so much for your time. We understand how busy you are. What is the latest from the hit zone and the latest response from police? Have you had any call-outs?
Yeah, thank you. So the storm at the moment is passing over Woodjill. The main part of the storm is about 70 kilometres wide, but obviously we're feeling the effects towards the south of it. Police have had no particularly urgent calls for service at the moment, but I know the State Emergency Service have had 109 calls, mainly around sandbagging, leaking roofs, trees down, things of that nature.
Sadly, Assistant Commissioner, history will show us that throughout disasters, people think it's acceptable to start stealing other people's property, to start looting. What is the message of the Queensland Police Service for anyone that thinks that this is acceptable behaviour?
Yeah, well, thankfully this is something that is very, very minor in terms of occurrences. We take an extremely dim view of it, as do the courts. If we catch you, and we will, you will be prosecuted.
For the Queensland Police Service, you've had not just officers that are already in the region, but some that have left here from the southeast. What is their role? How many officers have you got? Where are they at the moment? And I'm sure that they are well and truly ready to go.
Yeah, so we've pre-positioned 40 police up in the area to directly respond, but we have a large number just outside the impact zone who will move in once the storm passes.
Sadly, history once more shows us that it doesn't matter what warning you give to some people. They think that they know the area, that they're familiar with the surrounds of their properties, wherever the case may be. They think it's acceptable to drive through floodwaters. Firstly, it is an offence. And secondly, what is your warning to people that will drive through floodwaters? Because sadly, it always happens.
Yeah, so what we have to bear in mind, 12 people in Queensland lost their lives last year driving through floodwaters. People think if they drive through once and they get through, they're fine. They're not. It is an offence. The most you can hope for is a ticket from us for disobeying a road closed sign, or an appearance in court for driving without due care and attention. Or in some cases, and we do this, you will be charged with dangerous operation of motor vehicle causing death.
Assistant Commissioner, really thank you for taking some time out tonight. I think it's safe to say I speak for all Queenslanders when I thank you for your work and the efforts of all the Queensland Police Service. Melissa, it is imperative that if you do get into danger tonight, or anyone that you know is in danger, don't call the SES, call 000 immediately. Melissa?
Peter, thank you.